La possession 9 de mêlée, c'est partout. Chaque rock, chaque mêlée, chaque touche, on est derrière eux. Et il faut qu'on sorte le ballon le plus vite possible. Et on est partout, partout.
Okay.
The scrum half has a main role. Can you tell us what it is?
It's a key role within the team. It's pretty much the link between the forwards and backs. And obviously, if we're not at every ruck delivering the ball, which is pretty much our purpose on the field, is to deliver the ball to the forwards and to the backs.
Qu'est-ce qu'un match réussi pour un demi de mêlée?
En fait, il faut bien communiquer avec le 10 pour parce que le 10 il voit beaucoup de choses sur le terrain et il faut que nous qu'on parle beaucoup avec le 10 pour avancer l'équipe et pour mettre le jeu dans le même sens.
What are the skills do you need to play scrum off?
It's always good to have a good pass, especially being at a young age. You always want to try practice passing off both sides. Also, kicking is another one. Just exiting out of, getting your team out of dangerous positions on the field. It's always good to have to kick, and also just being game smart, like just knowing where you are on the field. It always helps.
Est-ce que vous vous sentez visé quand vous perdez un match, car vous êtes entre les avant et les trois quarts?
Oui, parce que en fait, comme je dis dans le jeu, peut-être dans les dernières 5 minutes, les avant ils veulent le ballon, les trois quarts ils veulent le ballon, et toi tu es au milieu, il faut que tu fasses un choix.
You both play scrum half. What is the difference between both of you?
Just being brought up in the southern hemisphere, we're molded into different kind of nines compared to the northern hemisphere, and you can probably see that. I know from the likes of the Aaron Smiths, TJ Perenara's, compared to someone like as in Danny Kerr, and I think they're in the European leagues now. They're starting to get more of that running game in their game compared to a traditional nine who just tends to pass. And we're in New Zealand, we're molded a lot to do the both run and pass at the same time. So yeah, I think that could be one factor.
Mon jeu, c'est un peu. J'essaie de jouer un peu plus vite possible pour le 10. Et j'essaie de temps en attaquer la ligne, mais ouais, on a deux jeux différents et je pense que ça marche bien tous les deux.
What inspired you to be a professional rugby player?
Just being born and raised in NZ, you grow up loving the rugby culture. It's, every young lad picks up a rugby ball in New Zealand, and it's pretty much you walk down to the local park and they're playing rugby there and you join in. And just growing up, I remember watching a lot of All Blacks games, when I was young was the time when Auckland, where I'm from in New Zealand, so they were at the peak of their era in New Zealand rugby. It was you play for Auckland, you become an All Black at the time. And so that really inspired me to wanna play for the All Blacks. Growing up as a kid in New Zealand, I think it's every young man's dream is to play for the All Blacks. And when it doesn't work out, you find other ways, but your love for the game is still there. It still remains a big passion of mine. And yeah, just to do it as work, as a profession, it's something you love to do. You don't wake up in the morning and dread not going to work. You wake up and you want to be, going to work and, getting money for doing something you love. Merci.
Merci.
Justin Bieber and Ed Sheeran.